Hey, what's up, guys? Bearcat here, doing another exciting episode of Bearcat Reviews, and today we're taking a look at the Mayfex John Wick Chapter 2 John Wick action figure. And I gotta say, I'm very excited to review this figure for you guys. I really like the John Wick movies, and I saw this came on sale one day, and I decided how to get it, because I was so much loving those movies, and still love the movies, and just seeing John Wick and getting to use it in person, it was just... It was amazing, especially the Mayfex version, because it's just the, I think it's one of the greater ones, especially with all the poseability and weaponry. But getting to that, as you can see on the box, you see John Wick and his little doggy in the window here. On the side, you got a picture of John Wick holding the shotgun. On the back, you see John Wick with different poses and different using different accessories from the figure. On the side here, you got saying John Wick Chapter 2, and it shows a picture of John Wick right down here with the gun. Not much more at the bottom, not much more at the top. So let's get to it and crack open John Wick. And here is John Wick out of the box. And I gotta say, he is an amazing figure. I've loved posing and taking photos of this guy because it's just amazing. Poseability's great. Everything about it is great. But to start off, we're gonna look at his accessories. So as you can see, here he is out of the box. And it's just with his open hands and his normal head sculpt. And he does come with a second head sculpt, which is this more beat up, battle damaged head sculpt, which these are easy to swap. As you can see, you just pull off this head sculpt, and then you just pop on this one, and there you can see that. So you can see that looks. And speaking of his hands, since I said he had two open hands, he does come with six extra hands, other hands. So to start off here, we got two fisted hands. A pencil holding hand, for you know what that's for if you've seen the movie. A gripping hand for his rifle. A trigger finger hand, and a hand to hold the shotgun, or if you want to also use for the pistol to help with the balancing pistols. And as you can see, they're not that hard to remove. You just pull them right off, and then you can slip it right back on. Slip on the new hand. And the same with the other hand, just pull it off. And then you slip on the other hand. And as for the rest of his accessories, he comes with a poseable stand for him, which I usually use to hold him, but surprisingly enough, he hasn't fallen at all yet. So, but as you can see, it just grabs on and it can pose. And there you can see, he's standing on the stand. So there we have that. And I'm going to hold him now because, of course, as soon as I say he hasn't fallen yet, he's going to start trying to fall. There we go. And his last accessories, other than that, is he comes with this little pit bull. Which you can see they did a lot of great detail on this guy, his little dog. You can see what it looks like with fur and everything, and the texture feel on it. And he does have a ball joint at the head, so you can move his head around. And that's it for the little doggy. That's all that can move on him. And as for the last accessories are, of course, his guns. And so he comes with his AR-15. His Benelli shotgun, and then his two Glocks, the smaller Glock and the bigger Glock. And as you can see, all the guns will easily go into his hands. You just slide it right in, and that's it. But now getting on to his poseability here, as you can see, he can move his shoulders up this far and down because of the hinge double ball joint here. Move up and down, rotate 360. A little bit of a bicep swivel up there. Double joint elbows. Wrists can move side to side or if you rotate it, it can move up and down. He's got a ball joint at the head, so he can look up that far, down that far, head pivot, and I'll rotate 360, or if you're me, pop his head off, apparently. He does have an ab crunch, so he can crunch forward that far. Back, not much, because of the or all the way off, because of his ball joint there. There we go. And he's got a little bit one of a ball joint here at the waist too, so he can crunch there too, or twist, do a little twist there. And for his legs, he has a little bit of a thigh rotation. He can kick forward that far, back not very far. The single joint knee that bends 90 degrees. Ankles can move down and up, but not very much because of his pant legs. He's got ankle pivot, but also limited because of the pant leg, and a toe bend. So now that we've showed that, let's get him ready for some size comparisons. So here we have John Wick and his little dog standing here ready for size comparisons. As you can see, John Wick stands just above, there it is, I knew he was going to fall eventually. John Wick is standing here just above 6 inches tall, and the dog stands just above 2 inches tall. So here for our size comparisons, here we have him next to our last figure review, the Silver Walgreens exclusive Silver Centurion Iron Man figure. So you can see how they scale together. Here he is next to the Toy Fair exclusive Snake Eyes figure for another Silent Killer. So you can see how they scale together. Because the season 2 came out this weekend and I've been very excited to watch it, here he is next to the Black Series Mandalorian figure. So you can see how they scale together. And last but not least, for your basic 6-inch scale comparison, here he is next to the Black Series Clone Wars Captain Rex figure. So you see that. And here is John Wick standing on the stand with his dog ready for a fight. I gotta thank you guys again for watching my video from start to finish. Again, I highly, highly recommend getting John Wick if you are a fan of the franchise. It is a pretty expensive figure since it's a Mafex figure, but it's totally worth getting. I very much enjoyed the movies, and if you're a big fan of the movies, I think you'll really enjoy getting this figure too. But like I said, thank you again for watching my video from start to finish. Please leave a like, comment, subscribe, let me know what you think, let me know what I can do to improve, and let me know if there's something you want to see, and I will try and get it and review it for you guys. Like I said, next week's videos, I will be reviewing another Persona Figma, because I had gotten requests to review more, and I really like the Persona game, so I thought I'd get another one and review one. So I was able to get another one, and I'm going to be reviewing it for next week's videos, for one of them. So stay tuned for that. Also, I will be eventually, I'm waiting till October ends, and then I will be getting my Mandalorian in the Beskar armor figure. So stay tuned for that also. But like I said, thank you guys again for watching, and I'll catch you guys on the next exciting episode of Bearcat Reviews.